In such dynamic times, we might and we should, we think, look to insights and orientation, certainly early warning and guidance from planetary boundaries, from a concept introduced by you, Johan, Professor Johan Rockström, in 2009. Planetary boundaries really defines 9 parameters, including climate change, water and land use. And as boundaries, they define crucial tipping points for humanity. As International Alliance Against Health Risks and Wildlife Trade, for example, we work on the very intersection between pandemic prevention and halting biodiversity loss. In fact, with our focus on wildlife and their use, trade, and consumption, our work is based on the very insight that the shared drivers of climate change, biodiversity loss, and infectious disease emergence provide an opportunity for collective action and resource efficiency.
In recent years, the consequences of man-made global environmental change are becoming ever more present. We experience floods, droughts, fires, storms, and current insecurities. Here in Europe, we see it, we saw it, but even more dramatically in our partner countries in the global south. As a global community, we are facing several interlinked crises, from climate change to the loss of biodiversity, war, food insecurity, and a still ongoing pandemic, which has reminded us of our own biology and close ties to all other species and the ecosystems we live in, as well as our vulnerability. Let's discuss today and in the future how transformative action can be integrated in our work, what we need to do differently in the future. So without further ado, we will now watch the documentary Breaking Boundaries, the science behind our planet and action.
The science is clear and has been communicated for the past 30 years, and still we're not moving in the right direction. I don't get depressed. I get angry. What are the systems that determine the state of the planet? This is about us. It is about our future.
All is not well with our planet.
As we increase our pressures on Earth, we are now crossing irreversible tipping points.
Nature is being degraded at a rate and a scale that is unprecedented.
When we emit CO2, about a third has ended up in the ocean.
There's no sign of any wildlife at all.
Based on the 7.5 million deaths, we have already crossed the boundary as far as aerosols are concerned.
As we manipulate the planet's climate, we're literally playing with fire.
Are we concerned about fighting the climate crisis? The window is still open for us to have a future for humanity. We still have a chance. What we do between 2020 and 2030, it will be the decisive decade for humanity's future on Earth.
Human health, animal health, and environmental health, the three are so much linked.
We've covered the whole planet with knowledge. The future is not determined. The future is in our hands.
Update number one, I say in the movie that we are at 1.1 degrees Celsius of global warming. We're not. We're at 1.2. There's data showing 1.3. So we're very close to 1.5. Actually, we may reach 1.5 within the next 15 years. That's number one. Number two is that the movie is done pre-Ukraine war. So my naive statement that let's put the planet in the United Nations Security Council, forget it, you know? We can barely get rid of Russia from the Security Council. So that is an additional challenge to exactly your question. Number three is that 4 weeks ago we published a major scientific synthesis in Science showing that at 1.5 degrees Celsius, we cross at least 4 of the big tipping element systems. So the latest science is not as the Breaking Boundaries documentary suggesting 4 of the 9 boundaries are in the wrong space, but 6 of the 9 boundaries. So if anything, it's even more urgent than what you saw in the documentary. What the planetary boundary science shows is, apart from the fact that it provides scientific evidence explaining why we're seeing all the extreme events and the impacts which are hitting vulnerable people, meaning people in poor developing countries hardest, explaining that. But it also shows something really important, which is that we must redefine sustainable development. Mm-hmm. We must recognize that the only way to lift people out of poverty, to have equitable and fair development for all human beings on Earth, is that we share in a fair way the remaining ecological space on Earth. The way I define sustainable development today is prosperity and equity within planetary boundaries. We have to recognize that the only way for Germany to have a prosperous economy and for Burkina Faso to have that is that we keep the global commons, all the planetary boundaries, all the tipping element systems within their safe space. This is the big drama. And in a way, when things went wrong in Wuhan and causing the pandemic, it's the same thing with the planetary boundaries when you think of it. If something goes wrong on Greenland ice sheet, or something goes wrong in the Amazon, or something goes wrong in the Siberian permafrost, it will hit back on us. I mean, it won't be exactly with the same speed, but it will have the same devastating undermining of our ability, irrespective of where we are, to develop. And I think that will not be done over the next few years, I agree, but if we can work towards that, because when you look at the SDGs, even the SDGs have goals 6, 13, 14, 15. These are planetary boundaries. 6, freshwater, 13, 14, 15, oceans, biodiversity and climate. They're not as well defined scientifically as the planetary boundaries, but they're there. What does this mean for the future? Well, to begin with, I think we have to start working really seriously with two time steps. One is to recognize exactly your point that there's less than 8 years left to deliver on Agenda 2030. We need to cut global emissions by half by 2030, and we need to halt loss of biodiversity. That, it's so clear. That's the roadmap. Deliver on the SDGs, cut emissions by half, stop losing biodiversity.